Hello everybody, my name is Vaethodas, welcome to this video. This is an update for the new patch 2.6.4 for Diablo 3, which will come this January, and we had the new patch notes released just yesterday in the website of Diablo 3, the official website. One of the new info that we have, or that we get, is that now Season 16 will start at January 18th, not 11th as they said previously. 1 week later. I don't know why, they don't say why, but this is what they say here, January 18th. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. The good thing would be for this new season to start before Christmas, actually, because many people are on holidays, but this has never happened. It will not happen this year again, so we go with 18th of January. So, now, we have some good things, of course, coming with the patch. We have tested the PTR already. For those that don't know, we had the PTR of this patch for 1 week to test. Let's see what changes we get. We get many numbers. They change many numbers in class sets to increase the performance of sets. We get quality of life changes for primals and all of these things. We will not go to each one of the changes and the new cosmetic rewards that they come with this patch at season. We will talk only about class set updates, class sets, because these are the most important things that this patch brings. At season, with the new season, we get the new season theme, which is everybody, all players, seasonal players, get a free buff of the legendary power from the Ring of Royal Grandeur. You get the buff, the legendary power, you have it always active through the whole season, without even having to farm for the ring, which you get from a bounty cassette from Act 1, when you play Adventure Mode. So, let's go down to the class set updates. This is the most important. Now, as Blizzard says here, the philosophy of the changes that they do with patches. For this patch, we got it to include a few frequently requested quality of life changes and focused on better celebrating and dedicating primal legendary drops. Okay, this is for quality of life, general. Let's go down. We have greater rifts, some changes with Paragon levels. We have the 16 season of Grandeur. And here we are, class set changes. Philosophy. We are taking another tunic pass across all class sets to improve class and set diversity at higher level, greater rifts. Some of these values have been adjusted per our observations as well as player feedback during the 2.6.4 PTR. Thanks for testing. So as we can see, what they try to do is they try to bring more builds to a higher, greater rift level, because currently, before this patch, there are only a handful of builds, very powerful. Especially Necromancer is very powerful. Since Necromancer DLC came out, it was a very powerful class, the most powerful class for high GRs. And now they are trying to balance the game a little bit and to bring more classes and more build diversity to higher levels of greater rifts. Much higher. This is a good thing. Of course, to do that, they use again this very bad thing that this game comes with, power creep. I never liked power creep. Power creep destroys action RPG games. But this game has this problem for at least 2 years now. And I mean, they are not going to fix this game now. They are working on the next Diablo game, so they are trying to keep the game alive. And I think this is a good change, because instead of nerfing the most powerful builds, they try to improve, increase the damage performance of less powerful builds and bring them to par with the highest builds. It is a good thing. It is better than nothing. At least more people that play on very high greater rifts will be able to play with more builds. They will have a better build diversity. There are many changes to sets. Most of the classes and most of the sets get buffs, huge buffs to their power. For example, as we can see here, Remnant of a Thousand Storms of Monk, the 6 set bonus has been increased from 13,000%. It is now 13,000%. Dashing Strike damage to 60,000%. This is stupidly crazy. It is, it is super, 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 super powerful. This is something like you will become something like Saitama for One Punch Man, something like that. But as we said before, they try to balance the game to bring more builds, more build diversity and higher, greater rifts. So this makes sense, I guess. There are numbers like this, or other numbers. We will not go through all of these changes, of course. I will put a link in the description if you go to come straight and check all of the changes at your own pace. What interests me more personally is this change here. Legacy of Nightmares. The 2 set bonus has been increased from 100% to 750%. 750%. That was a huge surprise for me and many other people, of course, because during the PTR, this was from 100 to 500%. We tested PTR with 500% loan buff. But now we get 750%. This news, it is amazing. It is amazing. This one makes me very happy. This patch is worth it only for this change, I could say, for me personally, of course. Because I like mostly, in action RPG games, I like mostly to try and create builds, explore build possibilities. I like build diversity. I think these games exist for you to make different builds and to have a different character, a different build from other players. It is not a game where you are all the same and you play the same style, you do the same things. I mean, if you go to be the same with everybody else, go and play a first-person shooter game where everybody is the same and you use the same weapons. It is pointless in action RPG games to not have a build diversity. And Legacy of Nightmares is a very good, it is a set, of course. Unfortunately, it is still a set, it is a mega set, but it is a good one because it was always a good one as an idea. It was a good idea because it allows you to create builds that are non-meta builds and to try and make builds of your own, builds, create play styles that you like playing with and go and play to a high difficulty level of the game. Of course, the game has 13 Torment levels. 13, Torment 13 is the highest level of difficulty for adventure mode. And if you go to go to Greater Rifts, of course, it goes up to 150. Yeah. Which is super high. It is very time consuming to go up there. But anyway, for people that don't like playing greater rifts, to go to the maximum all day long, and they like to have a build diversity and have fun with the game, I think Legacy of Nightmares is the best thing currently in the game. But the problem is that with the 100% currently that we get from this Legacy of Nightmares boost, this is not enough to make many builds and take them at least to Torment 13 and defeat Torment 13. There are some builds that you can make, but not that many. But with this increase in the power of the set to 750%, we will probably be able to create builds that use no legendary powers of items at all. Not at all. For example, there are items in the game for each class that have legendary powers, and these powers increase specific skills. The damage output of specific Sorry, the damage output of specific skills. Ah, I said it. So, for example, Wave of Light of Monk. Yeah. You have the Pit of Pride, Bracers, increase the damage of Wave of Light. You have some weapons, the Incense Torch of the Grand Table, things like that. Now, with this 750%, we will be able to probably to create builds that use no items like this. I mean, items, legendary items that don't have any buffs to damage output of any skills at all, and take these builds and defeat the Torment 13, and maybe even go up to GR 70, which of course GR 70 is the Greater Rift, where you unlock the possibility for primal ancients to drop when you kill enemies. Which is very good, because for example, let's say that a player wants to play season, but this player wants to make a lone build that they have in mind, their own build, and to go play season with this build. And now they want also to unlock the possibility of primals to drop on the ground, and they can take their lone build right now, with this patch actually, the new patch that will come. They can take their build up to GR70, unlock primals, and then start, for example, farming adventure mode or GR70, if not higher, and always have a chance to fight a primal item. I think this is a perfect change for the game, at least for build diversity. And of course, it is a very good thing that they now provide 5 more armory tabs, as we said before, but these 5 armory tabs are a bit useless, because you need to have more stats, much more stats tabs, many more stats tabs actually, because if you don't play just one or two build characters through the season, then you will not have enough room in your stats tabs to put all of the hundreds of and dozens of items that you need to have in your stats to be able to make so many different builds and save them in your armory tabs. This is a huge problem of this game. They still haven't fixed this problem. At least if they could make the armory tabs also to hold the items of the builds that you save on the armory tabs, that would be perfect, because the problem would have been solved. But they don't do that. I don't know why. Maybe they cannot. There is no I cannot in things like that. They probably don't want to do that. I don't know why they should do that. But anyway, this is the video, guys, an update video. Again, the season starts at 18th of January. The new season, this season will end at the day of January, I think. And I hope that the patch will land in the game before season starts. Something tells me that we will get the patch maybe 1 week after this season ends. So, we will see. Thanks for watching this video. Very soon I will upload a video with my first 3 lone builds that I have 3 lone builds right now in the game, and I'm very interested to see these 3 lone builds when I will equip the new buff, the new lone from the new patch with the new buff. I want to see how much more damage output these builds will gain. It will be a very interesting thing. And I will upload very soon a video to show you these 3 builds, and after that I'm planning on creating more builds, more lone builds, because, as I said before, this is what interests me the most in action RPG games, exploring build possibilities. So, thanks for watching this video, have fun whatever you do.